Good morning, students. Today we are going to do poem The Brook book exercises. Okay, question answer book exercise, whatever is there in book exercises we will do. Okay, so first of all, okay, one more thing I just want to tell, the thing which we are going to do, these all questions you will write in your notebook. Okay, whether these are there in your book or not, that doesn't matter. You have to write all questions from here. Okay, so let's start it. First, question number A, reads to understand. Find the lines in the poem that expresses the following thoughts. Okay, so from which line we got this thought? As the brook flows down its stony and pebble paths, it creates a whirlpool and makes many musical sounds. Okay, so it will be, I chatter over stony ways in little sharp and troubles, I bubble into redying bays, I babble on the pebbles. Okay, now second, the brook follows a winding path, carrying flowers and fish along with it. I wind about and in and out, with here a blossom sailing, and here and there a lusty trout, and here and there a gill. So these will be the lines there. Okay, now next question. When the brook flows above the stones and pebbles, there is a break in the flow of water, which appears silvery. So lines will be, with many a silvery water break above the golden gravel. Okay, now D, the rays and the beams of the sun appears towards dancing as they fall on the brook, thought through the cover along the shallow sandy banks. So I make the netted sunbeam dance against my sandy shallow. Next we can see here, next line, the brook continues its journey forever to the brimming river, unlike man whose life must come to a stop. So lines will be, and out again I curve and flow to join the brimming river, for man may come and man may go. Okay, so these will be the lines, but I go on forever. So now let's start question answers. Answer these questions. How does the brook behave when it encourage curves on its banks? So its answer, the brook feels unhappy and tired as it has to use all its energy to curve and move around and round, to move round and round again and again. So, comma, it behaves angrily when it faces curves on its banks. Now, next question number B, make a list of the various places that fall in the path of the brook as it flows. So, places that fall in the path of the brook are, number 1, 30 hills, second 20 small villages, next a little town, next a half a hundred bridges, next Phillips farm. Okay, answer number B. Now on question number C, we can see, what do you think causes the foamy flake the brook flows? Okay, its answer, when the water moves about a curve or strikes against stone, comma, it whirls and form large mass of very small bubble is referred here as foamy flake. Okay, next question, what makes the brook sparkle when it moves through the fern plants in water, shines bright, and water shines brightly with the sun rays falling it. Okay, so at that time the brook sparkles. Okay, next question, what is the netted sunbeam What makes it dance? The netted sunbeam refers to the sun rays filtered through the leaves and bushes that fasten the surface of sandy shallow water in a net-like pattern. Okay, the movement of water makes it dancing. Again, this answer, the netted sunbeam refers to the sun rays filtering through the leaves and bushes that face the surface of sandy shallow water in a net-like pattern. Full stop. The movement of water makes it dancing. Now question number F. Where does the brook in the poem originate from? The highlands or the plains? Support your answer with lines from the poem. The brook in the poem originates from the highlands because it passes through the high mountains, tough terrains, deep valleys and fine overcoming all the hurdles of the way. Okay? Comma, reaches destination, comma, the overflowing river. So what is the destination of that straw, that's a brook? The overflowing river. So again, the brook in the poem originates from the highlands because it passes through the high mountains, tough terrains, deep valleys and find overcoming all the hurdles of the way. Reaches destination, the overflowing river. Now discuss. Compare the following parts of the brook's journey with human life at the beginning of its journey. So its answer. As like a child, the brook chatters and babbles. It is as energetic as a human being, the initial stages of its life. Full stop. As human beings work to fulfill their aim in life, the brook's aim is to join the brimming river. This is answer number first. Second, closer to the river, the brook slows down and slips, slide and finds steals by the lawns and grassy plots. In the same way, in old age, man becomes quiet and understanding. Okay, so this is second. Now, so this part, C part, read to appreciate. This you will do yourself. Okay, what is there? Read these lines from the poem. I make a sudden sally by making a field and fallow. Both these lines have the use of alliteration. Find at least 5 more examples of alliteration. Okay, in the poem. So all those words which have the same sound in the beginning, okay, the same, we can say the same letters in the beginning, okay, and having the same sound are alliteration. So 20 tops, TT is there. So this is what? This is alliteration. Okay, I babble into a dying bass, I babble on the pebbles. So BB is sounding there. Below wheat, I slip, I slide. Okay, so here alliteration. That's all for today. Okay, now complete your work in your fair notebook. Again, I'm just showing you so that you can just better understand it. If still having any doubt, any problem, then you can call me. Okay, you are having my number, you can call on that number so that I can help you in this part. Okay, so complete this these things in your notebook. Okay, thank you so much for watching.